let's talk about active manifestation. If you saw the shorts that I just did, you saw me talking about that. And there have been some questions. What is active manifestation? It's not a common term. And how can active manifestation go on to help future manifestations? So stick around and let's talk about that, okay? Hi, I'm Marna. Thank you for joining me. So active manifestation is one of those things that sounds like a really bizarre term for a really, really simple concept. Part of manifestation is knowing that you cannot sit on your sofa and go, oh, the gods of money are going to drop it in my lap. I'm manifesting $1 million. It is going to suddenly appear in my lap, because it doesn't work that way. You'd be amazed how many people think it does. You cannot sit on your sofa and suddenly have the roof open up and drop $1 million in a block in your lap. No matter how cool that may be, manifestation does not create out of nothing. Manifestation brings to you that which already exists. So, now that we have that simple concept out of the way, what exactly is actively receiving your manifestation? To actively receive your manifestation, you know that what you have manifested exists. You know that it is within your grasp. You just have to reach out and take it. Now, how does this look in the real world? Well, let's take a look at the most recent example in my life of actively receiving a manifestation. I was in a situation where I did not like my job. I wasn't thrilled with where I was living. I wanted to spend more time with my children, and I wanted to spend more time with my grandson. So those were four things right there that I was manifesting, actively manifesting. Being able to leave the job, being able to move, spending more time with my children, and developing a relationship with my grandson. Yes, I was manifesting all four of these at once. Yes, you can manifest multiple things at one time. We'll do a video on that later. So, that's what I was manifesting. And I got a phone call. And the phone call was my daughter, who, the mother of my grandson, said, "Hey, Mom, can you help me out? You see, my daughter, who is a beautiful young lady, you may have seen her in the weight loss video. I'm going to post it up here just in case you haven't. My daughter works nights. She works late nights. Thanks to the whole pandemic thing, working late nights has made it really, really difficult to get childcare. And while her son is 6 and fairly self-sufficient, he's still a 6-year-old child and can't be left home alone. So, her solution was she asked me to move in with them. And that way, she can work knowing that there is a somewhat responsible quasi-adult watching over her son and making sure he stays safe, eats dinner, all that fun stuff." That was three of the four right there. The fourth part was for me to be able to move here. I would have to leave the job that I was not enjoying. Now then, this meant that for me to receive the manifestation, I had to take action. I had to agree to leave the job. I had to agree to leave not only my home, but my friend groups, my social circles, although they have been a bit hindered by everything that's going on in the world. But my entire life had to be left behind to move 600 miles to be closer to my children, because my son lives like 5 miles away. Be closer to my children, be closer to my grandson, and accept what I had manifested. Now, admittedly, when I was picturing the manifestation myself, I was hoping that they would move down to me so I wouldn't have to uproot my entire life. But We accept the manifestation as it comes to us, and we accept that the manifestation may not come in the exact form we wanted. So we roll with it. So I picked up, I moved 600 miles to share a home with my daughter and my grandson. I've been able to see my son a couple of times since we moved in, even with the pandemic. And I was fortunate enough to find another income source, so that has also come through in the manifestation. Yes, Boober is walking around and making sure that I produce this video correctly. He always does. By the way, Boober would like to remind you to please boop the like button. Thank you. Now then, what does this mean in terms of future manifestations? Well, I have proven to my subconscious brain and to the energy fields of the universe at large that I am willing to do whatever it takes to receive a manifestation. If you have seen my video of signs that your manifestation is coming, number 6 was increasing resistance from the universe. Obstacles showing up in your way. That's because the more you are nearing your goal, the more subconscious resistance you are creating by anticipating it. When you become someone who actively receives the manifestation, you are short-circuiting that subconscious resistance to what you're manifesting. You are going around that desire to anticipate what's coming, because it's no longer a matter of when's it getting here. It's now a matter of I'm stepping forward and taking it. That shift in energy alone makes the manifestation that much easier to bring in. So, to sum up, actively receiving your manifestation is choosing to take an action to bring that manifestation to fruition in your life, even if it's not quite how you thought it would look. Doing this short circuits the energetic resistance of anticipating that manifestation coming in, because you're no longer anticipating, you're no longer waiting. You're taking action to bring it to you. Now, how's that action look in the real world? It could be moving 600 miles. It could be opening a store and creating a product. It could be making videos so that you can reach out and help other people. How the manifestation looks is as unique as you are. What action you are willing to take for that manifestation is as unique as you are. No matter what, the manifestation you're working for is yours as long as you persist in bringing it to you. So, thank you for joining me, and I will see you on the next video.